Hello everyone, assalamualaikum. So here we'll take a look at Flutter game template. Now this game template has been released by Flutter itself. It means Flutter officials, they have released this code. And first, let's take a look at the game itself. So here, once you run your app, it shows up like this. Of course, as you see, it comes with here default audio that which starts automatically as you switch on the app or run the app. Now here, definitely first you see like this, then you have settings. So here you can change your players' names and the sound effects, turn on, off, okay, like this, and reset progress, things like that, okay? So you can go back and start to play. Now this is a very basic game, and it is a three levels, so you have to pass each level and then go to the next one. In the first level, it just asks you a very simple thing to do. So let's go ahead and click on this, we'll start to play. So it tells you drag the slider above 5%. So you have to do that, okay? If you do that, it shows you this confetti and it gives you score and time you spend, things like that, okay? Then you can go to the next level. So like this, so you understand how it works. Okay, so this is very basic game templating code released by Flutter officials. Now, the cool part is this is completely free, and I'll also put the link below where to find it, okay? And another thing is that it's completely responsive, so which means you can also play this game on web browser. So here I already launched it. Now as you see, it's the same effect that you see on mobile. Okay. You can do the settings from here and go back and start to play like this. Okay. Now it is completely responsive, as you see. So it responds automatically. Saying that one, actually, you can also use this template to build your own responsive website. And that would be definitely here. If we go to the settings page, we'll see that this is also responsive. It's beautiful. So this is the power of Flutter, which is responsive as well as very much cross-platform. Now anyway, we'll take a look at the code very quickly if you want to follow along. But I would give you just a very brief overview of the code, okay? Rest of the code is very well documented, so you don't need my help, you can view it on your own. Anyway, so if you come to the main.dart file, you will see that this is very different from ordinary main.dart file. Now over here at the top, we do have main.dart file, okay? And this is the first block of code for main.dart. Now here it starts with Crushalytics, which is for Firebase crush analytics, which means that if you connect your app with Firebase registration and register your app there, you'd be able to collect crush information for your app, okay? But of course, this is not compulsory, you can skip that. But if you want to put your app in production level, definitely you need this. And this is a new cool feature of Flutter 3, I believe. Okay, so now Crushalytics, you have to pass to a function over here, which is called guard with Crushalytics. Okay, now it takes two arguments which you need to pass. Now one is we already have Crushalytics, which comes from Firebase Crushalytics and guarded main. Now what is this one? Actually, this is right below there. Now guarded main is for logging. Okay, now this logging depends on plugin, so we'll see the plugin. But once you have this one in this section, so your app would be logged whatever it does, which pages you are going, and whatever information you want to log out, so more officially and a professional way of doing that one. So you might want to wrap your app around this one, okay? So until now, you see, we don't have really our material app or things like that. We are not dealing with anything like that. So far, we have dealt with how to get crush information and how to get the logging as the player plays the game. Of course, this is very useful logging when you do debugging mode, right? Now, this logging comes from here actually. So here you need to install this plugin. That's the logging. Okay, and they also used audio player over here. Now for playing audios. Now for this audio player, I do have a complete tutorial. If you want, you can check that out. We built a complete audio player using this audio players. Then they also used Go router for routing and a provider for state management and shared preferences for persisting information or saving information in the app itself. Okay, anyway, so yeah, for logging, you can use that plugin. And now this is for using whether you are going to play full screen or partially on the screen, but of course this is not compulsory. Okay, now this is ads controller. If you want to put ads on your app, if your app is popular, then you want to make money, so you can use this ads plugin. Now ads plugin actually is coming from here, Google mobile ads. Okay, so it's coming from that plugin. We also see that we have game services. Now, if you really want to put your games in Play Store, you have to connect your game with the Play Store console. Okay, and then you have to create an ID there and put it in your app if you want to do that. Okay, and as well as in-app purchase if you want to make more money. So you can also do this one where users they unlock various levels after paying money, or they buy different kind of things, right? Anyway, so that's where this ads controller and game services they come in, okay? And as well as in-app purchase, but these are optional, okay? All right. So now, first time here, we are going to see our My app, okay? So My app basically takes four arguments, okay? For storage settings and player progress settings and in-app purchase, ads controller, and game services. But for development purpose, debugging purpose, you can skip any of this. You can just work with any of them you like. You don't have to use all of them if it looks too complicated to you. So yeah, you can just skip them, remove them, and that's as simple as that one. If you remove from here, you can also remove from here as well. Okay, and then the routing is done using this Go route plugin. Okay, so here it's pretty much basically like other routing system, I would say that. Okay, so here home page. All right, and you mentioned the screen as well for home page and from different level and the settings, things like that. Okay, so here level selection happens and using this screen. So you just mentioned the path name, the route name over here. Same over here. Okay, and as well as when the user has finished the game, or if whether user won or failed, things like that. So we have this win screen and the setting screen. Okay, pretty much every time you have to pass this builder. Okay, well, you just mention your route name, then you have this builder, and then you have your screen name. But if you want to pass additional arguments, you can do it from here. Okay, so this is the Go route. And after that, here we'll see we have the actual build method that triggers running the app and building everything. Now, here we do see that they have wrapped everything around app lifecycle observer. Now actually these things are all coming from here inside the source code, as you can see. So app lifecycle observer, which is this one. But once again, this is not compulsory. You can skip that. You can just start with multi-provider. So any of the part you don't like, you can skip, just remove. Yeah, and that makes your learning faster. Because if you download this sample code, definitely want to learn it, you want to know the architecture. But if it's too complicated, you can remove part of this and then go ahead and do it. Okay, all right, so here we see that they have heavily used provider. Okay, as you can see, change notify provider, provider, things like that, and proxy provider. So if you want to learn more about provider, check out my other tutorials, which I have done on provider. Recently, I have released a couple of videos on provider. You can check that out. So here we see different kind of providers. So this provider is more reactive. This provider just only works with single instance, which makes sense because it's connected to game services. You just get one value from game services and then you are done. Same over here. So you just wanna work on certain values. If you wanna work on multiple values at the same time, you would use a change notify provider where you can work on multiple values for state management. And over here we also have proxy provider, proxy provider 2. Now we use proxy provider 2 if we have to depend on other providers. So here we depend on settings provider, as you see. So first settings provider has to be initialized, then app lifecycle has to be initialized, and then we'll initialize our audio. So a lot of this two information, a lot of the information from settings and app lifecycle is used by this audio controller. So that's why you want to initialize that two first and then use audio controller for state management for audio itself. So you use proxy provider, okay? All right, and this palette is another provider for creating colors. So you for settings purpose that is used. Yeah, and then at the end we see our material app, but this is wrapped around using a router. I think each routing system have their own way of doing things. For example, if you use GetX for routing, then you would use here get material app like that. Okay, then you have to bind your route over here using this route delegate and the route information parser, just like that. So here, pretty much all the code is here actually. So you can check out on your own. If you have any questions, you can put questions in the comment sections. Okay, and I'll try to reply because I have gone through this code pretty much. So just let me know. All right, so thank you so much, and welcome to Flutter game development.